Welcome to Analytics with Nags.
In this session, we're going to see about what are variables and expressions in SSIS. Both are two different topics, but it is closely related. You will create expressions using variables. That is how it is related. Let us try to see in this video what is the purpose of these two. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notification. We are familiar with our precedence constraint. What is this? When it is success, go to this task. When it is failed, you can go to another task. So this is what we have learned in our previous sessions. And there is another option called completion. This is fine. But in certain cases, I do not wish only the success, failure or completion to evaluate what process to complete. I need to check some conditional check like expressions. Like instead of checking whether it's a success or failure, the completion of the task, you check some condition, then you do this task. What such conditions? So let's say when the date, right, today is 29th of January, when it is greater than 25th, execute this task. I mean, every month you are daily running this task, but you need to check whether the date is 25th or greater than 25th, then only you need to run this job. Or you want to run this particular task on 25th or 27th or 29th of a particular month. So such a conditions you want to check. So let us make it very simple. We will check our date, okay? Whether it's greater than 25th, then run this task. Otherwise, don't run. Then we will try to change the condition and check it. So for that, the expression, what I want to do is there is some kind of functions over here, get date. Okay, let us try to drag it. So get date, and I will add another part, date part. Okay, so here I will mention DD. So date part of DD will get me the date. Say for example, the get date will get me today's date. Okay, and the DD will give me 29th, that particular day of the month. Okay, if it is greater than 25th, okay, today is 29th, so it will evaluate to true. And if it is less than 25th, right, today is 29th, 29 will return here, 29 is less than 25, false, so it will evaluate to false. So only if it is true, so I will change the condition here, the evaluation condition, 29 is greater than 25, so evaluate it to true. Then you run this. So now you can see here, the instead of only using the constraints, the precedence constraints, success, failure, completion, I also encountered or included a condition here. This is what basically the expression is. So let us try to do it here. So what we are doing in this case, it is evaluated to true. Let us try to run this package. Now we are in merge join all. Okay, and there is merge union all. Let me run this package, execute package. So we have enabled the data viewer inside this, that's why it appeared. So this execute pass task is written to return the calci, that is why it came. Now this is what basically I want to highlight. So expressions used to write some condition. Let us make it fail. Okay, I will change this condition to less than. Okay, what happens now? Let us try to run it again. So this time you see this flow is not at all bent. So similarly, using the success, failure, completion precedence constraint, you also write some conditions to make you can control your flow. That is what the point is. Now we understand the purpose of the expression. Okay. Now I want to make it dynamic. Like if there is some particular record, okay, this is the condition over here. Okay, I will duplicate it here. I will make it as constraint once again. So I want to implement here. Now I want to load this record, okay, into target, but I want to check how many records in this particular table in my source. If there is more than 100 records or more than 10 records, then only I need to initiate this remove and then load it. Sometimes there might be some issues in your source, you are removing and loading. So in that case, if there is no records in the source, then accidentally you remove and there you won't load any data. So only if there is some record exists, then only you load it. So basically you need to store, you need to get the result, okay, from the source and then store it somewhere. For that you need to use a variable. So variables usually typically in any programming language use it to store data or result temporarily during the flow of execution. Okay, same way now you can have the data resulted from execute SQL task, or you can store or create a variable like over here. Right click and new. Let us try to say like if the date is 25th, instead 25th you want to make it dynamically, these variables can be passed from outside or from the execute SQL task. Let us try to make it dynamically. Okay, first thing is like date. Okay, now here I'm saying the first example. Okay, date part. So instead of directly giving it over there, I can give this value over here. Okay, 25th. So in this condition, okay, I have given here, instead of giving 25 here, I can get it from here. Okay, this is dynamically will change. Now it returns false because 25 is less than, I mean 29 is less than 25, that part I have kept 25. Okay, that is why. So this is one way of doing it. So basically variables are used to store some result, so this can be changed from outside, that is why you are giving it here. Okay, let us try to check it later how we can do it, but this is the main purpose. And another scenario is like as I told before, now I want to check in my source how much record is there. So my source here is Naga store sales data SRC from Naga store. Let us try to get that query first. Okay, general, and it is Naga store select count of 1. Let us try to write the query here from Naga store. The table is here, sales data source select star from, this is the one. And what I want to check how many records. Okay, if the record exists, then I want to keep that one. So it is cnt. So assume I want to check this, if this count 8161 over here, okay, the result set, it's greater than 100, say, because sometimes in your source it may be truncation, there might be no records. So you want to ensure if only if the record exists, you execute this flow, otherwise do not do anything. Such a conditions you can do it. For that, let us try to get this result. Okay, you need to have this particular query, so it will be having cnt. Okay, let's keep like that. Then you create a variable to store that result set. So it is sale src cnt. Let us keep it like this. It's integer, and there are different data types. Let us walk through it later. Now for this it is integer. Okay, default value is 0. Now go to this execute SQL task. here, then this execute SQL task returning some result, okay, result set, okay, you say single row, okay. If it is a full result set, then it is returning entire table that will be stored in some other object, okay, object data type, in object data type variable. Now in our case it is a single row with a single column, so just keep single row, okay. Then here you need to choose obviously Naga store, okay. Then parameter result set, okay, here result set, the result set name is nothing but your output column name. Here in the CNT you are getting, right, this is the result set name, okay. Here you are need to map that should be stored in user sales SRC count. Just keep that one. So get sales count, okay. So in your source you are checking how many data it contains, and then you can create a sequence container that can store entire process like this. I mean all this to be done, okay, inside this. So how you need to generate, only if the count greater than 100 then you do it. So let us try to see this one. So where you can write, here you can write like expression, then you can choose from the variable here sales. Here you need to write this is greater than 100, evaluate, false, because now the value is 0. 0 is greater than 100, false. That is why it is false. You remember, like where you can see the variable, the value of the sales count is 0 now. Let us try to change it to 10,000. Okay, so this will be overwritten while execution. Now you go and test this. Now it is true. Now it's returning because 10,000 greater than 100. This is absolutely fine. So this is how you have written it. So while running this package, what happens? So this will get the count, and you have written a condition that is greater than 100. Yes, because you see here this is 8169 records, it's available, then it will become true, then this flow of execution will occur. Okay, let us try to check it. Yes, this is absolutely true. Now you can see like the data is flown through it because the condition is passed. Now I want to desperately fail it, like only if there is more than 10,000 records, okay, then what happens? Let us try to execute it again. There you go. So it doesn't pass because the record is only 8,000 records, whereas you have only I mean your condition is failing because you are not passed the condition. The one more important thing I want to highlight is, like here you can check uncondition, that is all constraints must evaluate to true. Okay, basically you are saying you do only the expression. So we are already know this is only the constraint. I mean to say, this is, if you are not having the expression, this is only the constraint. And when you have expression, you are checking only the condition, based on that it will flow. And there is an option to choose whether you want to do both, like you want to check the expression as well as the constraint. That is, constraint means it should success, and then you the expression also, this expression also to be evaluated to true. Otherwise you can press R, expression R constraint. So either this expression should be passed, that is resulted to true, otherwise constraint means that the task should be succeeded. So now earlier we have kept expression, now what happened, this flow has not executed. You can see this has stopped. Now let us try to change this expression or constraint to expression or constraint. Okay, now let us see what happens. Now this has flown through. Why? Because this is the main issue. I mean, it's not an issue. This is the main behavior. That is what I want to highlight. So now in this case, the last time we have run, the expression is failed, but the constraint is success. Constraint means the execution of this particular task is success, then you do it. So this is the main objective of your variables and then expressions. So both are closely related. So most of the purpose you will use it, and in your upcoming videos we will see where you can use the variables and expressions. So these will be used when you want to do everything dynamically, and the input should be supplied from the outside the package. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.